Support for the Nature Museum is provided by Rose Pest Solutions, protecting homes, businesses, health, and the environment since 1860.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Curious by Nature. My name is Erin, and on this week's episode, in honor of World Wetlands Day, we're going to learn all about aquatic turtle habitats with Pancake, the Nature Museum's spiny softshell turtle. Let's go see what Pancake is up to. So we're here in Mysteries of the Marsh looking at Pancake's habitat, and we're going to explore the different adaptations this unique animal has. What's an adaptation? It's a special feature an animal has developed to better suit its habitat, and Pancake has three very distinct adaptations. Let's start with that shell.
Softshell turtles get their name from their leathery and moderately flexible carapace, or top part of their shell. Having a shell that is so flat allows Pancake to thrive in the water. First, he can swim easily and quickly without a domed shell, like a box turtle's, and he can bury himself in the sand or mud for a quick escape from any predators. He can even bury himself and lay in wait completely unseen by unsuspecting prey.
As well as that unique shell, Pancake has some very unique feet. Let's take a look.
What do you notice right away? Pancake has webbed toes, which helps him swim quickly underwater to chase prey, like fish or crayfish, and escape predators. What else do you see? He also has long claws on the ends of his toes. He can use these claws to dig into the sandy or muddy river bottom, bury himself completely, and hide for prey to come his way, then quickly pop out and grab it.
By now, you've probably noticed Pancake's very special nose. Let's take a closer look.
One of the most distinctive or noticeable adaptations on a spiny softshell turtle, besides that shell, is that nose. Since each of his nostrils are at the very end of that nose, he can extend his really long neck, poke that very long nose just above the waterline, all while keeping his body out of view from hungry herons or even raccoons.
So we've taken a closer look at three very distinct adaptations that help Pancake thrive in his fully aquatic habitat. That snorkel-like nose, those paddle-like feet, and that very streamlined shell make this animal very unique. That's our show for today, and thank you so much for tuning in. I know Pancake appreciated his first critter connection in a while. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like below, and don't forget to subscribe so you never miss an episode. You can also help us take good care of all of our animals at the Nature Museum by making a donation at naturemuseum.org. Thanks again for joining us today, and we'll see you back here on Curious by Nature.